Welcome to Coda iOS. Sites let you get to work quickly in Coda iOS by connecting to your servers and remembering your settings. Here's everything you need to know to get started with them. Before we begin, on first launch, you have the option to set up Panic Sync or to start coding. If you don't know about Panic Sync, our free service that allows you to sync your site and server data across Panic apps, please check out our Panic Sync overview video. Okay, onward. Here's where you'll access all of your sites when you're using Coda. To get started, tap the plus button. You have the option to create a new site or a new group of sites. Let's keep it simple by choosing New Site. There are three tabs in this view. By default, we start off in the Site tab. It's the one with the leaf icon. While we're here, let's give our new site a name. And check this out. If you want to pick an icon to represent your site when you see it in list view, you can do that right here. We have some ready to go, or you can choose your own image, or just go with your site's favicon. Or is it fave icon? Who knows? Bonus points if you want to add a local path here. That's the path to the local folder of files you want to start in when you connect to the site. Now that the hard part's over, let's actually set up our server. We'll switch over to the server tab. That's the one with the globe icon. By default, our connection type is SFTP, a secure file transfer protocol that is almost always at port 22. Your port number is automatically set depending on which server protocol you chose. You can change it if you need to, but the default should work in most cases. Your server configuration will determine what type of protocol you use, and we'll go over all of Coda's server protocol options in a moment. But for now, let's set up a server with Coda's default, SFTP. Enter your server's address, then the username and password associated with it. If you're not sure what those are, check with your web hosting provider or server administrator. And for an extra layer of security, you can use secure keys instead of a password. See our video, Using Keys in Panic Apps, for more information on how to do that. No matter which server protocol you use, you can enter your preferred remote path here. This is the folder you'll be placed in by default when you connect to this server. It's also the base folder for generating preview URLs. And the remote URL field is where you can enter the root URL for your website. This will be used to generate a thumbnail image for your site and will be the base URL for previewing remote pages. Okay, this might be all you need to set up your site. If so, feel free to stop here and move on to the next Getting Started with Coda iOS video, or skip the tutorials and just start coding. Using something besides SFTP? No big deal. A lot of the setup will look the same, but let's go through all of Coda's server protocol options now. FTP with implicit SSL is another commonly used secure protocol for file transfer. This one uses secure socket layers instead of SSH, which is what SFTP uses. The implicit in the name means that the server will only allow a secure connection and automatically creates one via SSL. This protocol listens via port 990 by default. FTP with TLS/SSL is yet another secure file transfer protocol, but this one uses the standard FTP port of 21 to connect, and then explicitly switches to secure mode only with a special command of auth-TLS or auth-SSL. And then there's FTP. This is plain old file transfer protocol. We don't recommend choosing this one, as it's less secure than the other options, but it's still in use on a ton of sites, and sometimes it's your only choice. Note that all three of the FTP protocols are in passive mode by default. This means that Coda connects to the server for data transfers instead of the FTP server initiating the connection. Let's have a look at the WebDAV section. WebDAV is yet another file transfer protocol, but this one is meant to be used when collaborating with multiple people because it lets you do handy things like easily see who last changed a file or lock down files so that only one user at a time can modify them. You'll see there's the standard option, which uses HTTP and listens on port 80, and WebDAV via HTTPS, which is the newer and more secure version of WebDAV, and by default, listens on port 443. And finally, you can also use cloud computing services, like Amazon S3 and Dream Objects, with Coda iOS. Whichever server type you choose, you'll need to enter your credentials. The last tab in the site settings view is the terminal. Chances are, you won't even need to use this tab, but let's go over it anyway, shall we? You can enter the address for your SSH server. It's usually the same address as your web server. The default port for SSH is 22, but you can change this if you need to. Once again, fields for your credentials. They're probably the same ones you used before, and again, you can choose to use a secure key instead if you'd like. The startup command field is a bit of an advanced option that lets you automatically send a specific command to the server each time you connect. The terminal type can be changed if needed, but leave it at the default if you're not sure about this. It defines how information will be exchanged with the remote server. By default, Coda will automatically connect to the remote server when you create a new terminal session. What's this delete sends caret H toggle for? Coda has a delete key. but some servers expect a different command for delete. So if you find it not working quite right, try flipping this switch. And finally, agent forwarding. You can toggle this switch to enable it. This will allow Coda to use the local SSH agent on the remote server, as if it were local there. Note that this involves some extra setup that we won't go into here. Phew, that should cover everything you need to know to get your sites up and running in Coda iOS. Oh, one more thing. If you ever need to edit your site info after you've set it up, use the edit icon right up here. Be sure to watch the rest of the videos in this Getting Started series to become a Coda iOS expert in no time. For more information, visit panic.com.